Hello.
What's up, man? What's up, man?
Yeah.
What's up? He is a cutie. He's a cutie.
Boom, so now I'm in the car. I am at Olive Garden right now. Me and Dominique decided to come to Olive Garden because...
Oh! I guess y'all knew. This is why y'all wanted me to react to this shit, because y'all knew I was going to laugh at the Olive Garden reference. What is good, Diamond Dynasty, baby? Welcome back to another motherfucking video.
There's a lot of girls with me right now. Got a lot of drugs with me right now. But I'd rather just get
that. Let's not go too soon now.
I feel the same. And a lot of girls hit it mine now.
Hey,
I would rather pass that one to you like we used to do.
And today, baby, y'all already know what the fuck going on in this goddamn video. As y'all can tell by the title of the video, y'all already know what I'm about to cover in today's video, okay? So, a lot of you guys wanted me to react to Chrissy, motherfucking uncensored, you feel me? And I have heard a lot of things going on with this goddamn video, okay? Of course, I have not seen it yet. I wait to react to shit with you guys, so I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys have already seen this motherfucking video and y'all are just coming to see my reaction to it. However, I do know it has something to do with baby Damo. The title is Vlog with My Son and Never Fucking Posted It, okay? / Chrissy Uncensored. All right, so we're gonna get right into this video. Once again, I want to thank you guys so freaking much. We're almost at 95 motherfucking K. Appreciate you guys from the bottom of my motherfucking heart, the bottom of my goddamn balls that I never motherfucking saw, okay? Because I ain't got no goddamn balls, okay? So I do have a shout out for today. I want to shout out my nigga Eat or Starve, okay? That is his YouTube motherfucking channel. He does ASMRs. He does a whole bunch of food videos. Y'all gonna watch that nigga eat, and y'all know I love to eat, okay? So I'm gonna show y'all a little clip of one of his ASMRs. Flaming Hot motherfucking Cheetos. I love Flaming Hot Cheetos, even though they burn my booty hole sometimes, and I know they're not good for you, but the motherfucker's good as hell. This clip is probably gonna make you crave some goddamn hot Cheetos, okay? So let's get into the motherfucking clip. Here we go. So if you are a foodie like me, I fucking love food, okay? Make sure that y'all subscribe to his motherfucking YouTube channel. Once again, it is called Eat or Starve. That was his Cheetos, Flamin' Hot Cheetos, ASMR. You can watch his full video. The link is gonna be down in the description down below. Shout out to Eat or Starve once again. Make sure that y'all follow him on all of his links down below. Subscribe to his motherfucking YouTube channel. I appreciate you guys so freaking much. I love you guys so freaking much. 100K giveaway is coming soon. I'm going to release the details of the giveaway once I hit 100K, okay? I'm going to do the actual giveaway, I think, on the 26th, January 26th. So, y'all be looking out. I'm about to hit 100K here soon within the next few days. If I don't hit it by New Year's, it's all good because I'll hit it shortly after New Year's. I'm not tripping. I appreciate you guys. We have made it this far and we only gonna keep fucking going up, okay? I love you guys from the bottom of my heart, man. Let's go ahead and get right into this motherfucking video. Make sure that you like this video. Comment your thoughts and opinions down below. Make sure that you share this video with a friend. Hit that bell so you can be notified every time I post another lit ass video. Make sure that you DM me at DZStudology101 and let me know what I should react to next. And tell a friend to tell a friend today. Ain't Jemima today, Uncle Joe. That nigga's still a hoe. And let's get right into this motherfucking video. Let's get it, y'all.
Good morning.
What's up, baby Damo? What's going on, my guy? What's going on, man? I would love to meet baby Damo. He got so much motherfucking character and goddamn personality. Like baby CJ, Chris's son and Queen's son. Got so much goddamn personality, okay? That nigga be trying to meet everybody. But look at baby Damo. That nigga so goddamn cute, brushing his goddamn teeth and shit. Look at that.
What you look doing? At this nigga. You brush your teeth for mommy?
Just
you
look at him.
He's looking at me.
Why baby Damo look like a grown ass motherfucking man already, okay? And that's not no shade at all. But this nigga always look like a fucking grown man, bro. He got grown man expressions and everything, you feel me? This shit is crazy. People always try to call me while I'm filming a motherfucking video. I can't take your call right now, my G. Sorry. Where? So y'all Twinkies.
Mm-mm.
Brushing your teeth at the same time. That's cute. That's cute. Leave me a comment down below and let me know if you have one of those racks. One of those shoe racks and shit. I ain't got a shoe rack. I make a rack on the floor. On the motherfucking floor. And the motherfucking, that's just how it's gonna go. My shoes is lined up right there. It is what it is. Hey, I don't give a fuck. I ain't got no goddamn shoe rack. Leave me a comment down below. Let me know if you have a shoe rack. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to all the cancers in the building, because I'm pretty sure either y'all have a shoe rack or maybe y'all don't. You know what I'm saying? Maybe y'all don't want like shoes laying all around. I've seen a lot of people say, well, I'm not a cancer, but I like cleaning products and I like to keep my... Hey, ain't nothing wrong with that. You feel me? I'm not saying that it's specific to one zodiac sign, but I do know a lot of cancers, their kick, their whole gig is cleaning. Cleaning like shit. You feel me? It's crazy, okay? Shout out to the cancer.
What's he doing over here? He loves to play with this thing. You look so adorable.
That nigga Baby Damo, he be playing with any motherfucking thing he can get his goddamn hands on, okay? Baby Damo will play with anything in sight, you feel me? So, no pun intended, y'all nasty. I was not thinking about that. But I'm just saying, anything in front of him, he gonna play with, you feel me? He gonna entertain his motherfucking self, okay? Shout out to Baby Damo, okay? I would like a baby like Baby Damo, because it seems like he not in anybody's hair. He's out the way, you know what I'm saying? He just doing what he does as a baby. He likes to play with whatever the fuck is in front of him. And that's all he got to say in this bitch, you feel me?
My baby looks good in all black. Cute self. You ready to eat? What you want to eat? I know you guys probably seen these, but oh my gosh.
That nigga look like a grown man, you feel me?
Look at my grown baby.
He say. What's up, lady? You know what I'm saying? What's up? Hey. It's Baby Damo in the building, you feel me? Holla at me. Slide in my motherfucking DMs. Boom. Okay.
Yeah. I'm gonna send these to my family. She gave me the CD so I could print some pictures out.
I don't know, Chrissy, because, you know what I'm saying? She's saying you ain't family no motherfucking more, so I think the rest of your goddamn family is disqualified too. You feel me? I don't know. But we gonna see.
Oh my gosh, my little sailor wig. Look at this face. This is my baby. This is my child.
Leave me a comment down below. Let me know. Do you feel like, regardless of, because I know niggas gonna be in the motherfucking comments talking about signing them goddamn papers, okay? We get it. She should have signed the goddamn papers. Fuck the goddamn papers at this point. All right? Do you feel like Chrissy is Baby Damo's other mother? Leave me a comment down below. Let me know whether yes or no. Chrissy is the other mother, or Chrissy's not the other mother until Damo finds somebody else to fill that spot. I was about to say void spot at the same time. Until Damo fills that spot with somebody else. Leave me a comment down below. Let me know if you feel like Chrissy is worthy of the mother title. You know, this one's kind of tricky because it's like Chrissy didn't initially want a baby at all. And let me also just say this about Chrissy, all right? Chrissy was what, 20 years old, guys? I know me at 20 years old, I wasn't ready for no motherfucking child, okay? And say I get with somebody, I'm vibing with them, I love them as a person, we connect, we decide to get into a relationship, and maybe my girl has been wanting to have a kid for quite some time, even before me, before I came into the picture, you know? But I love her, and I'm trying to accept her for her, all right? I don't know how I would feel if I told my partner, look, you know what I'm saying? Eventually, I do want kids in the future, whatever the case may be, but right now, I'm not ready to have a kid. I'm just not ready, you know? I would want my partner to understand that and try to compromise with me. maybe we can wait like a year or two to see what our relationship is going to go, where our relationship is going to go, so we can build some type of foundation for just us two first. Because when you bring a baby into the picture, it's going to complicate things, point blank, period. Because then all the focus is directed to the goddamn baby, okay? So if you don't have a solid foundation in your relationship and you bring a baby into the picture, this shit is going to be chaos. You feel me? Leave me a comment down below and let me know if you feel the same way. That's just how I feel, 100%. You know, first you have to build a solid foundation with your partner before you bring a baby into this world. Now, let me also express Damo's side. Damo's side is, look, before I even met your ass, before I picked your ass up at Olive Garden and gave you a whole new life in this bitch, lifestyle. Came straight from Olive Garden to my lifestyle, okay? Ever since that happened, you feel me? I also can see where Damo is coming from, because Damo did say that she told Chrissy, I told your motherfucking ass, I was already wanting to have a child, you know? Even though Damo is young too, she wanted to have a child. They got into a relationship. She told Chrissy that they wanted to have a child. So people are saying there's no excuse for Chrissy. But at the same time, you have to realize that Chrissy was 2021. I can't even fathom having a fucking child at 2021. Not saying that it's wrong. People have had children at 18. I'm not judging anybody. You know, you do what you do. But I would, you know, as Damo, you know, Damo wanted to have a kid. And I see it from her perspective too. She's like, well, shit. You know, we happen to get in a relationship. We happen to fuck with each other. We happen to like each other enough to get into a relationship. I made this decision. Bitch, get it together. I made this decision to have this child with or without somebody. Totally without somebody, I would have been fine. But you came into my life. I enjoyed your company. I came to the point where I'm saying I love you now, and you're my girlfriend. We're in this relationship shit together, you know? But I don't mind just taking the full responsibility to be a mother to my son that I want to birth, because I really want to have that baby. You know, whether it's with you or without you, you don't have to have any rights. You don't have to be in the child's life whatsoever. Let me also say this. On Chrissy's behalf, I would have to say that to me, it would be kind of a fucked up situation. Me at 20, 21 years old, making a decision about a fucking baby, and I'm still a goddamn baby trying to figure shit out in life. You know, like, to me, it will be a lot of pressure, especially if my girl, we're a public fucking couple, okay? Public fucking couple. Everybody knows our goddamn business. And for my girl, my girlfriend, to say on social media, hey guys, I'm just gonna have the baby myself. You know what I'm saying? Chrissy's not ready for a baby. Whoa, you know what I'm saying? As Chrissy, I would probably feel some type of way too. Like, yo, chill, like, I didn't say I never wanted a baby with you. I'm just not ready for a motherfucking baby right now. You know, you're trying to have a baby right now. You're trying to let out the goddamn kids right now. And I'm just not ready. And I feel like I see where both parties are coming from, guys. I see where Chrissy is coming from, where she would, like, if I was Chrissy, I would be like, damn, I feel some type of way because I feel like my girl's not trying to compromise with me. You know what I'm saying? I wish my girl would at least compromise and say, hey, let's try this relationship shit for a year or two. And then, you know, let's have a kid together. And let's see how that goes. Let's see first if our relationship can stand the test of time before we fucking bring a whole nother human being, a baby, into this fucking world that we gotta raise. You know, while we're still trying to find ourselves. You feel me? I feel Damo's situation and her perspective too. Damo's like, well, bitch, you ain't gotta be the goddamn baby mama. You know, you knew going into this relationship that I wanted to have a fucking kid right motherfucking now. Doesn't matter how young I am, you know? Doesn't matter if I'm with somebody or not. But I made the decision in my mind and in my heart and soul that I wanted a baby now. You know, for whatever reason, I'm not quite sure. So I see both sides of it, guys. I see both sides. You can't really be mad at Chrissy because she wasn't ready to be a mother. She agreed to it. I mean, I would have felt like I was in a rock and a hard place. I would have felt the same way, because I'm like, dang, I love this girl. I want to be in a relationship with her. Everything's going good. But then again, I don't want a fucking baby right now. You know, and she's not trying to compromise with me. She's trying to have a baby right away. I'm like, fuck. So you're kind of stuck in that situation. And when your girl don't compromise and she go do what she want to do anyway, you start resenting her on some type of level too. Just think about it. She already didn't want to have a baby. She wasn't ready to have a baby. I know I'm talking a lot, but this is something that I really wanted to clarify, because I see a lot of people in the comments just bashing the fuck out of Chrissy. You have to realize that Chrissy is young as fuck. Damo is young as fuck. Okay? Chrissy wasn't ready for that shit. And imagine you being in a relationship with somebody. In a fucking relationship with somebody. And let me also say this. I don't think that Chrissy was always this way towards Damo. Like, when I look at their first videos, especially the one I'm probably going to react to it, guys, when Damo asked Chrissy to be her girlfriend, I saw genuine vibes in that video. In the very first videos, like the beginning of the relationship without baby Damo and shit, I saw authenticity and genuine vibes, genuine love right there. So I just want to get that out the way. Y'all leave me a comment down below. Let me know how y'all feel about what I just said, okay? We got to try to see both sides of things. We got to try to show love to each side, you know? You got to kind of try to put yourself in each person's shoes. I know everybody wants to hate and bash Chrissy right now, but what if you were Chrissy? Put yourself in Chrissy's shoes, you feel me? How I would feel some type of resentment, because I would have felt forced in a way. Because whether or not, like, I'm already attached to you, I already hang with you, you're already like my best friend and my lover, and you're saying that you're going to have a baby with or without me. What the fuck? You know, like, what the fuck? So that's already gonna make me resent you in some type of way. And then when you get pregnant and the baby comes and shit, I mean, it's just not gonna be good vibes, because I told you how I felt. I felt like you didn't compromise with me. I felt like you just wanted to do you. In a relationship, there must be compromise. There must be communication, compromise, and trust, and a whole bunch of elements, you know? Maybe that's some of the reason why Chrissy stepped out. Because she was like, well, shit, you know, like, she didn't respect my opinion. She didn't respect the fact that I wasn't ready for a kid. I know I'm talking a lot. Let's go.
Oh, I just love this boy so much. Do y'all see him?
So that nigga is active. This is a grown-ass motherfucking man. Y'all can't tell me shit,
some chicken nuggets, some vegan chicken nuggets, and
let me find out some vegan pasta. Chicken nuggets.
I
got me some
right here. I love.
That shit look good as hell, to be honest.
Pepper. Yeah, he seems to like
I love pepper, too.
But he likes the chicken nuggets. More what he's familiar with. He's had pasta before, but he hasn't had it in a long time, so he's probably confused. But obviously, he's eating it, because it's on his little tiny fingers. Is it good, Wick?
He said, hell yeah, it's good as fuck. That nigga ain't paying you no motherfucking mind.
Get out of here. Look, wait.
Hey, turn up.
That's my son. Wait. Now he wanna get out. I was trying to.
Once again, I'ma defend Chrissy in this respect too. Chrissy didn't have to take no motherly role. She didn't have to. But she stepped up to the plate when it was necessary, you know? I feel like she did step up to the plate when it counted. And a lot of people are like, well, oh, she's just doing it for views. She's just doing this and that and blah, 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 blah. But what if deep down inside, what if Chrissy is really hurting that she can't see her motherfucking son no more, you know? I'm just saying, I'm not saying that she's not full of shit, because she might be. But I'm also saying that we don't know for sure that she's full of shit. So why not just give her the benefit of the doubt? And I know a lot of people were in my comments like, why should we give her the benefit of the doubt? I done been done wrong before when I was trying to give the motherfucker the benefit of the doubt. And I understand you done been through whatever you've been through. We get it. We've all been hurt before. Okay? But I feel like everybody deserves to get some type of defense. When everybody's bashing one person, I like to play the devil's advocate sometimes, just because I feel like there's more than three sides to the story, okay? There's more than three sides. So y'all leave me a comment down below. Let me know how y'all feel, you know?
Expose him, because you know. Oh, hello.
What's up, man? What's up, man? What's up? He is a cutie. He's a cutie.
Yeah. Boom, so now I'm in the car. I am at Olive Garden right now. Me and Dominique decided to come to Olive Garden because
I guess y'all knew. This is why y'all wanted me to react to this shit, because y'all knew I was gonna laugh at the Olive Garden reference. Maybe she did that shit on purpose, talking about some motherfucking Olive Garden, because she knew niggas was gonna talk about that shit. That shit is hilarious, okay?
Because he told me that he wanted Olive Garden, and see, you want Olive Garden, baby?
It sounds like a yawn. So we're here. We're just gonna eat and then go back home. Because I was gonna go to the park, but then it got dark, and then I was gonna go to Walmart, but then I was like, why am I at Walmart? So we're at Olive Garden because we have a reason to be here because we're hungry.
Our food, I got them a cheese pizza.
Yo. Why does Chrissy have to be extra? Like, is it necessary to be as extra as you're being, Chrissy? Like, what the fuck, dude? Like, what the fuck? I'm just confused. I guess, you know what? Like, just seeing it from her perspective, she's probably getting bashed to the point to where it's like, she has to have, like, a little hint of extraness. I'm pretty sure she's extra anyway, but I'm pretty sure she's over the top because niggas is coming at her the way they coming at her, you feel me? So I feel like, once again, her defense mechanism steps in to basically make her feel better, you know? So even though she might say some harsh shit sometimes, even though she might do some dumb shit sometimes, she might say something stupid, she might, whatever the case may be, I feel like it's just out of defense mode, you know? Like, she's getting bashed so fucking much that it's at the point to where, like, I know it's affecting her, guys. I know it is. And I know a lot of people are going to be in the comments like, fuck Chrissy. Yeah, it should be. I hope it's affecting her. I hope she dies in hell. But it's like, does that really benefit you guys? Does that really benefit Chrissy? All those negative vibes and negative energy? I don't think so. You know? I'm not trying to say that everybody should just be positive about the situation and just let Chrissy off the hook for the dumb shit that she has done. But let's be honest here. There has been some trifleness. Yes, I made that shit up. Trifleness on both behalves, on both parties' ends, on Damo's end, on Chrissy's end. Let's be honest. Neither one of them are saints. Neither one of them are free from blame. They both took part in some type of way for this bullshit that's happening right now. You feel me? All I got to say is I pray for baby Wiki. I pray for Damo and I pray for motherfucking Chrissy. But I just really want them to get their shit together for baby Damo. I feel like eventually Damo will allow Chrissy to see baby Damo. I just don't see Damo being that vindictive and that spiteful. She could be. I don't know. I just don't see that she will never let Chrissy see baby Damo again. I just don't see it. Like I said, it could be a situation where she does. I don't see it. Leave me a comment down below and let me know if you think that Damo will never allow Chrissy to see baby Damo again. Leave me a comment down below.
Put some fries, but they're cooling down right now. I did give him one and he's satisfied. I gave him a piece of bread and he just not want it. And I got him watching Mickey Mouse, I think. I don't know, something. But he's watching it. Are you hungry, Wick? Don't wait for it to cool down, Wick. So I just got back home. I'm about to take a bath. I need to get the mat for the floor. I couldn't think of what it was called. After I give him a bath, I'm gonna clean. And maybe I'll have him color something while I'm cleaning.
Hey! Now you can't deny, like, even if Chrissy did some shit just for views, so did Damo, let's be honest. They both did shit for views, okay, you feel me? They did. But from what I can see, Chrissy did have moments where she was a mother to baby Damo. Leave me a comment down below and let me know if you agree or disagree. I understand there's gonna be a lot of people. I know I have an unpopular opinion because I try to take both sides. I try to be unbiased. I know sometimes I'm more biased than other times. I'm not a saint, nigga. I'm not fucking perfect. I don't claim to be fucking perfect, nigga. In a perfect world, we would all be motherfucking perfect and the world would just go round and round and yeah, we would kumbaya. But this is not a motherfucking perfect world. But I do think that Chrissy did step up when she didn't have to. Yeah, you could say that she stepped up just for the cameras and shit like that. But even if she just stepped up for the camera, she still stepped up. I know that might sound dumb, but I'm pretty sure there's a lot of moments that she spent with baby Damo that wasn't in front of the fucking camera. You know? I'm just trying to say, see it from both ends. Try to put yourself in both of their shoes. Put yourself in Damo's shoes. We have all done that already. Put yourself for once in Chrissy's shoes. And, you know, I'm not trying to say that you would do the shit that Chrissy does by any means. But try to see where the fuck she's coming from. Because at the end of the day, we're all fucking human beings. We all fucking make mistakes. And we should all just forgive, move on, and fucking love each other. That's what I'm saying, my nigga.
You already know. Look like... Yeah! Here, take a bath. He's like, why am I not in there?
He is a cutie. He is a super cutie.
You're about to get in, fat boy.
Super freaking cutie.
You ready to get in the bath?
Get in there, boy.
You ready to get in the bath?
Boy, boy. He said, I don't know about this. That water pressure coming down, man. He's a cutie. Hey, baby Damo about to be macking some hoes, pimping some bitches in this thing. Not too long from now, I'm telling y'all, man. He's gonna be macking some bitches in this thing.
But he still wants to be in there.
He ain't done. My nigga's swimming.
Wait,
right now,
bro.
Time
to get out, fat boy. Wait.
He's swimming.
Alright, you know what? It's cool.
You gotta take his ass out, okay? Oh, he sleep like a baby.
Well, he's...
I know this is off topic, but boy, when I did the motherfucking ice bath challenge, oh my God. When I tell you, like 15, 20 minutes after I did the ice bath challenge, y'all, I swear I was only in there for like 7 or 8 seconds. But when I say I got the best sleep that I've ever had in my motherfucking life, I got the best sleep that I've ever had in my motherfucking life. Let me know if you've done the ice bath challenge or if you've done some type of icing in the tub and you fell the fuck asleep like crazy. That was like a hypnosis. The best fucking feeling that I could ever fucking feel in my goddamn... Well, I can't say that. No pun intended. But, yeah. Anyway, let's watch the rest of this 27 seconds and we gonna be out.
Sleep for the night.
He knocked out, boy. Knocked out.
Look at him. He was tired.
Nigga was out of there.
You love me?
Yes.
Well... That was my reaction, guys. I know I said a lot of shit. I know I talked a lot. So for all the motherfuckers who want to say I talk too much, blah, 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 y'all should know that by now. And if you don't, now you know. So click off my motherfucking video, okay? Y'all already know where to see the motherfucking video. So if y'all got something to say, I ain't got nothing to say to you because you already know I talk a motherfucking lot. So it is what it is, all right? I love you guys so much, man. Like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, comment your thoughts and opinions down below. Make sure you share this video with a friend and hit that bell so you can be notified every time I post another lit ass video. Make sure that you DM me at DZStylology101 and let me know what I should be reacting to next. And tell a friend to tell a friend to today ain't your mama, today Uncle Joe. That nigga's still a hoe. And I will see you guys in the next motherfucking video. Love y'all, man. Peace.
None of that hate really bother me. YouTube 3 years, they don't wanna see me blow. They don't wanna hear the flow, but this usually how it go. Bankroll, bankroll.